for a while there. I was a little worried about what was gonna happen, yeah?
Mmm.
For a while
there. Okay.
We leave as soon as Yuna returns. I trust you'll be ready. We leave as soon as you...
Listen, if Yuna gets married, then I...
What? That again?
Yes. If she is to marry, I would want her to marry for love.
See?
But if Yuna said she wanted to marry the one she loves, I would have to object.
Huh? You're not making much sense.
I know.
Yep, because you don't know stuff yet. Why is Lord Braska no longer here? Ooh, spooky.
Lulu?
I've talked enough about that.
What?
I'm sorry, just forget about it.
Jeez, grumpy.
You'll understand one of these days.
When you grow up.
I just don't want to give it words, not yet. I shouldn't have to say this, but don't fall in love with her. I see. But you must keep your feelings inside until the pilgrimage is over.
I would have gone for the you're more my type thing, but for me, it kind of, if I was actually Tidus, I would have ended up saying, too late.
I'm a little worried about Lord Jiskal. I wonder if Maester Seymour has heard.
For a while there.
Riku, where is Riku? We haven't spoken to Riku. Hello.
We leave here. We have to go through the Thunder Plains next, you know? I can't stand thunder. I can't stand...
Thunder and lightning, very, very frightening. Where's Calamari? Where's Calamari? Or am I just being blind and he kind of blended in with the background somewhere back there? No, I do not know where our big blue Ronso has gone. Unless he's inside one of the houses. Well, who do I speak to now?
We leave as soon as...
Okay, we leave as soon as Yuna is ready. When will Yuna be ready? We already got the primer. Ah, there he is.
Guado potions, good. Buy some before leaving.
So, that's basically like your cat going, I like this cat food. Buy more.
More than a guado.
More than the guado, at least. What? Okay, nothing new. I mean, I have 20 of everything. I could buy more, but I kind of want to save up so I can get good equipment next time there's good equipment for sale. There he is. Okay.
I'm a little...
Okay.
I wonder if me...
Okay. Okay.
Summoner not with you?
No, she's at Seymour's place.
That's Maester Seymour, or Lord Seymour.
Oh, I'll be careful. Sorry.
That's all right. Oh, Maester Seymour left Guado Salam a short while ago.
You serious?
I believe he went to the temple in Makalania. Maester Seymour is also the high priest of that temple.
Whoa, I gotta tell the others.
I think they all know. No, they were just conveniently all in a semicircle for you to tell them.
Lord Driscoll, please tell me. What can I do to help?
Yuna, let's go!
Don't fuck my son!
They say Seymour went to Macarena Temple.
Macarena.
Macalania Temple.
I?
What I don't get is, why would the Lord Maester head off without a peep to anyone?
Maybe he wasn't expecting Yuna's answer so soon.
Ah, that's probably it.
Yuna, what is it?
Oh, nothing.
You're a poor liar.
It's true, it's nothing. Come on, let's go.
Hey, Macarena, aye! That's the first time I've ever noticed that. That's amazing. I never realized. Well, I casually stand in semicircles when I'm with my friends, just in case someone needs to tell us something. I don't. Then again, I don't have friends.
Oh no, we're here.
I love you, Miku!
How are we supposed to cross that?
See the lightning rod towers? The lightning is drawn to them, hopefully.
We head north, not too near and not too far from the towers, yeah?
Meaning we should avoid wide open areas.
But there's items!
I think I forgot something in Guado Salam.
Nice knowing you.
Okay, I'll go!
Lightning can strike kitten! On the I almost read that as Ganondorf. Gandalf Thunder Planes. Lightning can strike you any time, so keep moving. The lightning rod towers absorb nearby lightning. Seek shelter under them. When you are there are no towers nearby, you can dodge lightning by pressing Nyeh. Hit Nyeh as soon as you see a lightning flash. If successful, you can dodge the thunderbolt. Constantly mashing, however, can be dangerous. Good luck on your journey. Yeah, I'd bang Riku, despite the fact that she is 16. It is legal age in Japan, so it is okay. Well, Yuffie was apparently like 12 or 14. Damn it. I thought I was close enough. You don't die from lightning strikes. Not necessarily. Many people have survived lightning strikes. Google it. Electro Marble. Japan, it is also legal to marry your cousin. I love Japan. Well. Okay, good. God dang it. The world record is one guy who got struck by lightning more than 50 times over the course of his life. Lightning never strikes the same place twice, apparently. Yeah, everything here seems to be weak to water. Because it's the fucking lightning plains. So basically, anything that has water strike on it is OP. I don't think I have many water strike. Things. Ah, I do for you, because I have one of everything for you. I do for you, although maybe I want to keep poison touch. Don't for you. Don't for you. Don't for you. Okay. Could I customize it onto something? What would I need? Stuff that I apparently don't have any of. Hello, boys. You know what? I should really switch you out for Kitten.
Miss me?
Wait, am I using? I'm not using Brotherhood. And we lost Sensor because nobody has a weapon with Sensor. I could use sticking sensor on no weapon. He was in different places. His life was relatively short and unhappy. Many people believe that there was some paranormal shit behind it because he got struck by lightning at least twice a year after his first strike. Roy Salavan. Oi? No, this is liquid steel. It's just got the same model. No, after that is Brotherhood, it evolves into that form after being in the far plane. No, it doesn't. Holy shit! I also had Brotherhood, which has evolved to have several different effects. However, that wasn't what I was looking at earlier. No! Brotherhood is awesome now. It's one of those weird coincidences like getting hit by a meteor. Yeah, Brotherhood does. However, I wasn't using Brotherhood at the time. I was using Liquid Steel. It just happened to have the same model. Because there's only so many weapon models. So whilst I'm here, my goal is gonna have to be to steal as many Electro Marbles as possible. Because they will likely be useful. But there was one guy who survived Hiroshima and got moved to a different hospital in the other city. He got moved to Nagasaki. It's alright, Ptinga. Yeah, they Riku is Final Fantasy X's Yuffie, and Final Fantasy XIII's Vanille is their attempt at a Yuffie. And the Yuffie, then there's Selfie, who I think is kind of similar as well. It's like they do stuff
Please
like that.
Make it rumble.
Cause they found out that people liked having that kind of a character. And so they included it more.
Oh, yeah.
Or something like that, maybe. I don't know. What happens if I combine two potions? Does it just make an ultra potion? Yeah! Oh, it max health. Riku just gets, like, immediately fucked. It's hilarious. He did manage to survive both atomic bombs. Yeah. Not sure if that's lucky or not. Yeah. Yeah, you always need the happy-go-lucky character to make it so that even if, you know, horrible shit is happening in the game, there's something to provide comic relief and lift it up. It's also always a cute girl, because it just appeals to the people that are into that kind of stuff. Or something like that. I don't expect to get hit by lightning as soon as I get out of combat. I just don't. She hates
Let's
thunder. They want revenge. All of your Electro Marbles belong to me. Stop killing Riku! Especially stop killing her with thunder! God damn! It's just like, yeah, I really don't like thunder. Boom! This is why! I keep getting one-shot by it! There was also Violet Jessup. Nice girl, was a nurse aboard 40 ships. Survived 10 of them sinking. Her last ship was the Titanic. Well, that is unfortunate. Lucky and unfortunate at the same time. I realize that this probably isn't going to do any damage, but may as well. Oh no, it did. Okay. God fucking damn it, every time it's immediately after combat for some reason. And it's pissing me off. It's just the fact that you get into a fight and then you still have to deal with, like, immediately after. Why? How? Why? You see why horses in Frigid Outskirt reminded me of this particular horsey. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, I do. I see it. Stop fucking Riku. She's not like that. A petrified grenade. Well, that's a thing. This area inspired the entire Final Fantasy 13. This is a long, boring, annoying hallway with the same enemies over and over. Like I said, they want revenge. Hey, Mafig. How's it going? This game gets hard later on. I wish they'd set you on the right path to get the certain abilities and items you need, because I have to backtrack a whole bunch. At least it gives you the ability to backtrack. Lava. Yeah, Final Fantasy X is actually quite linear. Lunar Curtain. Ouch. So I can only steal one item per enemy, that confirms it. Is it healing itself? No? Okay, good. Good, let's kill it just by whacking it. Can I do that? Yeah, I can do that. I really need to fucking level Riku. A wide ring. God damn it, I pressed it too early. Pressed it too fucking early. Hmm. What's that one go towards? Yeah, we need that. Because otherwise she'd be headed up towards... Provoke. Yeah, she doesn't need that. She needs to head up there. The same trick in Final Fantasy X Part 2 works here. No, yeah, I actually quite enjoyed Final Fantasy 13. Towards the end, it gets really, really good. It's just that, yeah, at the start, it's not exactly great. It's just because Final Fantasy XII was so open, and like it wasn't a game with a world map. They've taken a step away from the world map. They might bring it back for Final Fantasy XV. I don't know. They updated the Final Fantasy XV demo today, and I haven't tried it out yet to see what they've added. But... Yeah. It's not a great game, but it's not a bad game. Personally, I don't mind it. It's definitely not the best. I prefer other Final Fantasies, but I don't think it's as horrid as people say. A large part of the time, I think people are overly critical just because they want to get mad at something. Final Fantasy 13 and 13 Part 2 still sold really well. Otherwise, there wouldn't have been a trilogy. That's how it works, you know? I stole its musk. I literally stole the stink off of it. Ugh. Oh shit, Riku's petrified. What, Bartangelus? That's not necessarily indicative of much. There's lots of non-memorable main villains in games. But at the end of the day, it was basically that the Final Fantasy team was trying to take a step in a different direction. Some people liked it, some people didn't. It's just got, I feel that it's gotten an unfair rap because, you know, granted it wasn't great and definitely Part 2 wasn't very good. But that's the nature of it. Final Fantasy X Part 2, I think, sucks. I hate it, mainly because of the story. Because it just shits on the story of 10 in turning Yuna from being a girl that has actually got some depth to her to all of a sudden being like, yeah, girl power! It's just like, eh. They're not sisters. They're from the same village. And in their society, villages were considered to be extended families because they were small populations. If you think about it, if it's a small village, everyone's related. That's just the nature of the world. They're not confirmed to be a couple. However, there's nothing saying that they couldn't be. Yeah, and nowhere does it actually say that they are sisters, I believe. At least not in Final Fantasy 13, as far as I know, or Final Fantasy 13 Part 2. Might say it in Lightning Returns, as far as I know. Then again, I've never played Final Fantasy Lightning Returns. At the end of the day, does it matter if they were a couple? It really doesn't. They had some kind of love for each other, whether it was familial or romantic, doesn't matter. They both wanted to look after each other and shit. So, you can try and read into it if you want, but I don't think there's much point. If you want them to be sisters, you can project them being sisters. If you want them to be a couple, you can project them being a couple. Again, this comes down to the whole thing of, you know, unless it is something confirmed as being canon, you can project almost whatever you want on certain characters. If they're if two people's relationship isn't confirmed as being something, there you go. You can immediately, you can come up with as many theories as you want, and it doesn't fucking matter. Vanil is too young. She's 16, and she lives on Grand Pulse. If you consider Grand Pulse to be similar to, like, if you were in that kind of an area, they would be old enough as soon as they had their first period, similar to back in like medieval times. Because it's kind of like going back into that. It was like they regressed into that sort of era where they had to live off the land. There was very little automation. And society, while it had grown, hadn't necessarily grown into a structured place with a government and things like that. It was a collection of towns. Because that was all that there could be. Why are we talking about fucking Final Fantasy 13 during a Final Fantasy 10 stream? And why are we talking about the things that aren't actually necessarily fucking talked about? Like, can we please definitely not talk about Lightning Returns, because I haven't played that yet, so anything you say is possibly a spoiler for me. Just saying. But yeah, Final Fantasy 13 Part 2 wasn't as good. Bits of it I liked, but there were certain parts of it that were just annoying or shit. Yeah, and that's your opinion. But you, again, have to recognize that other people like it. Other people might like it, rather. No, don't worry about it. This actually happens quite a lot, particularly during the less active parts of a stream. Margin does respect other people's opinions. He is just a little bit of a troll, and so he likes to get arguments and he likes to get opinions and stuff. I'm not saying that he's doing anything wrong. It's just that he likes to pull this kind of stuff out. He doesn't necessarily mean to do it, but he does. Haha, bitch! Two in a row so soon! A strange stone. Can't do anything with the cactar stone. I'm gonna have to end the stream soon because I am tired. And it is 1 a.m. Yeah, it's fair enough. There is a lot of stuff in Final Fantasy. Yeah, Martian and I quite often will like start a random conversation on Steam, and then this sort of conversation will be what comes out of it. No, it's not FF Gamer. However, last night I was up until 6 a.m. working on my chatbot on stream. And, well, I was streaming until like 5 a.m. and then I just couldn't sleep for another hour. So I had a particularly late night last night. And didn't get a lot of sleep because of it. Also, there is a difference between just casual gaming and streaming. Streaming actually takes a hell of a lot more energy than you'd think. Alright, FF Gamer, well, I hope to see you around, I guess. Have a good one. I can heal everyone after the fight's over. That's what Kimari's for, the little healing bitch. I deliberately did that very, very quickly. Okay, I was waiting to see if I was going to get struck by lightning again. Thankfully, no. I think we will make it to the next save point and then call the stream there. Because I am tired. No, yeah, everything is should be open to criticism. I agree with you there, Martian. However, everything also has the timing. There's correct times to do different things, and that goes to be said for criticizing things as well.
Good day.
Hi there.
Is it true? I heard that Maester Seymour and Lady Yuna are to be wed. It's such great news. I have to tell everyone.
Where'd you hear that?
From the Guado. They were all very excited.
Huh. I'm afraid you heard a little wrong. Yuna's gonna turn him down.
Oh, really?
Yep. No wedding.
I see. That's unfortunate. Well, I'm sure that people would have rejoiced all over Spira. Oh.
All right. Good night, Margin. Have a good one, man. Probably see you tomorrow. You had to perform some favors for Elder Scrolls Online. Sexual favors? Wait, it's you we're talking about. Of course they were sexual. Hey, Tinker. You're coming in towards, back in towards the end of the stream. I'm gonna end when we get to the next, save point. It was a slow day in GameStop. You were the only customer. You found out you didn't have enough money. So, was it a man or a woman? And so, okay. So it was a man. Well, at least you did it safely, and you're still here, so... Well, I say that because I know that you're bi, so... It was even more that so than other people. It's like... possible that it could have been either gender for you. There's this hot skinny girl with a purple nose ring. Ah. And so are you going to try and set up a similar thing to happen with her? Is your goal to try and fuck or be fucked by everyone at that GameStop? It'd be an interesting goal. I don't know if she wants to. Lens, you sly dog, you. Oh. the water ball. Maybe it's on my bucket list to sleep with all the employees of the local GameStop within a month's time. Oi! Well, at least you use protection. And I say that legitimately. Or literally, rather, not legitimately. And then as soon as I say that, and maybe I'm protected with the two hottest employees if they want. Right. God damn it, you fuckers. Stop doing the lightning immediately after a fight. Shit.
So, how shall we do this?
Use water, that's how. Although we've now lost the person that had the sensor. Apparently. Wait, no. Do the thing with the thing. There we go, there's the thing. Fuck it. Damn it. So I'm just keeping Riku in my party at the moment so that I can try and get as many materials as possible from stealing to be used in customization or getting abilities and crap like that. It's Blizzara, not Blizzarda. Yeah? Blizzara. Both my Lulu and my Yuna have the Aras. Welcome back, Savato. I don't know. Everything up to this point, potentially. Uh, No lens. I'm using the expert sphere grid. So I haven't. I didn't grind it much. She just doesn't know Cura yet. When you start a new game, you can choose which sphere grid you want to use. The expert sphere grid just gives you more choice. However, it does, it lets you, like, rather than being as restricted into the paths for each character from the start, it's a little bit more open, so you can, like, move into the different trees earlier. However, there are less nodes, and so at the end of the game, you will have, when you've maxed out the grid, you will have slightly lower lower stats. And so that's the trade-off.
Whoa, that was a close one.
Stop kidding around.
Yes, ma'am. what's wrong?
You're giving me the creeps.
Hey, I want to go home. I hate lightning. I hate thunder. Let's go rest over there, please.
This storm never stops. Better to cross quickly.
I know, but just for a little while.
Well, what now?
This is why you have to love Riku. At least in this game.
Just a few minutes. I'm scared of lightning. Let's rest, please. Pretty please. I'm too young to die. You're mean. Cruel. Your moms would be ashamed of you. Are you having fun doing this to me?
Fine. Rest. She's worse than the storm.
That's why you love Riku. You have to.
I'm a little tired. Do you have a room available?
Ah, Lady Summoner. Yes, just over that way.
Thank you.
Yuna?
It's not like her.
Oh. Original copy of A History of Summoners, Thunderplanes Edition. I thought it was a primer. Long ago, fiends known as Quackdars roamed the Dose continent freely. They ran rampant, ravaging fields and tormenting travelers. Then Lord Gandalf appeared, a man later to become High Summoner. He scoured the continent for the Quackdars and drove them to these plains. Once he gathered the Cactars together, Lord Gandalf linked the sign of Meh. Wherever the Cactars turned to smoke and were absorbed by a stone, the Cactars were thus sealed into stone, fated to face lightning day and night. Until someone again blinks it, sign, and releases the seal. they shall suffer within the stone for their deeds. Thus did Lord Gandalf bring relief to peoples all over Spira. He believed the battle with sin was only one part of a summoner's greater mission. So I need to press the square button next time.